Good morning, everyone. We continue here in the Kitzur Shulhan Aruch in the laws of Hava of lending money to people. Just like it's prohibited for the lender to put pressure on the borrower to repay him. As we mentioned yesterday, you can't even walk in front of the borrower if you know that he doesn't have the money because you'll make him feel bad. So too, it's also prohibited for the loiver, for the one who's borrowing the money. He's not allowed to withhold the money that he borrowed from his friend in his hand. And tell him, go now, I don't have the money now, go and come back later for the money. When he does actually have the money available to pay off the loan. So if Reuven owes Shimon $100 and he's got the money in his hands to repay, and Shimon comes along and he says, no, pay up, and he says, nah, go away, you'll come back another time when I'll give you the money then. You're not allowed to do such a thing. Shinema, like it says in the Pasuk in Mishle, you're not allowed to tell your friend, go and come back. That itself is a chutzpah to do such a thing. When you have the money to pay, you're supposed to pay. We don't demand the other person to come back and work on our time schedule. Also, it is prohibited for a borrower to take the money that he got through this loan and wasted, squandered on foolish things until he gets to the point where it could be lost. He won't have the money anymore. And the lender, the one who gave him the money, will have nothing to collect with anymore. Why? Because the loive, the one who borrowed the money, he ended up squandering it all away. Even if the one who lent the money is very wealthy, and the person who borrowed the money does such a thing, he says, nah, what's the big deal? So I waste the money. I only got $1,000. What's $1,000 to this to him? He's got that much money in his pockets. And plus more, it doesn't really matter. So what's the big deal if I waste the money and I can't pay him back? Someone who does is Nikra Rasha. He's called a wicked person. Shinema, like it says, a wicked person borrows money and he doesn't repay. The sages taught us, your money should be as precious, your friend's money should be as precious to you as yours. Which means that if I borrow money from somebody, I have to treat it the way I want people to treat my money, which is give it back to them when the time comes up for payment. If the malva, the one who loans the money, recognizes that the one who's borrowing over here, shubal mida zois, he possesses this trait, which means he squanders his money, he doesn't pay attention really, and he has disregard for other people's money, mutav shalalahava is thought better that you should not loan him the money at all. Mimashi yalvehu, then to loan him, why? Because afterwards, when he won't pay, you're going to have to pressure him. And every time that you pressure him, every time that you have to put pressure on this person to pay you back, you're going to be transgressing the prohibition of do not act towards him as a creditor, which means don't put the pressure on him to pay back. So therefore, if you have the money to loan other people, but you know that this person is a shyster, he's a trickster of sorts, and he takes money and uses it for other things and he doesn't pay back, you're better off not loaning him the money, because at the end of the day, what's going to happen? You're going to have to pressure him into paying, and you yourself are then going to violate a commandment in the Torah. Have a wonderful day.